Good evening, everybody. Today's topic is coal box inspection and cleaning methods in coal box coal making. Content of the presentation: inspection method of coal boxes, cleaning of coal boxes, preventive measure during the production run to avoid these issues. First of all, we will see inspection method of coal boxes. It is important to have good input quality, to have good output quality in each of the stages. So we know that if input quality is good, then only your output quality will be better. So to have good quality of core, one must have good quality of core box available for the core making processes. Hence, inspection of cleaning of core boxes plays an important role here. So inspection and cleaning of core box plays an important role to have better and consistent quality of your cores. Also, when you start production run, you have to do some preventive work to maintain the core quality. So you do it before start of core making, but during the production run also, you need to have some preventive work need to be done. And we will discuss that in today's presentation as well. So inspection method of core boxes, we have a checklist for core box inspection. There are 7 points we are talking today. Number one is core box name and identification. Number two, core box finish. Number three, core box doweling. Number four, core box handle. Number five, core box damage, if any. Number six, core box vents, that is air vents. And number seven, core box parting line after core box closing. So these are the 7 points we are going to see each and every in detail. First one is core box name and identification. Each and every core box must have identification available on the core box and also on the rack where the core box is kept. This will help person to get right core box at minimum searching time. So your searching time will get reduced if you have a proper identification on core box as well as in the rack. Core box finish. Core box finish depends on the core box finish. So core finish is depending on your core box finish. So maintaining core box finish is important. Before start of core making, every time one has to clean the core box to maintain the core box surface finish. Use core box cleaning agent for cleaning the core box. There are many core box cleaning agents available in the market. You can take any one of them and just apply it with the brush and clean it. I have shown some of the photographs how to apply and how to clean the core box. I have also shown a couple of photos, a good one and bad one, before cleaning and after cleaning photographs of the core boxes. Core box doweling. Core box doweling is one of the neglected area in the core box inspection. Most of the time, we do not give much attention or importance to this area, and this results in mismatch of cores and dimensional inaccuracy of the cores. So if dowels are not properly, it is worn out or it is not fitting properly, the core box will not close properly, and it will give issues like mismatch of core and dimensional inaccuracies. I have shown some of the examples here. The about the worn out dowel holes and dowel pins, and some pick about the right type of dowel holes and dowel pin. One has to check it periodically. One has to check it daily when you start using the core box, and you have to change it periodically. Whenever you find that your dowel pin or dowel holes are getting worn out or it is getting not as per requirement, you can just go and change it, because it will give you issues with the core shifting or dimensional inaccuracy. Core box handle. So whenever you are making coal box cores with a manual way, there will be a handle to push in the core box, and also for the lifting the core box while ejecting the core. So that handle has to be very rigid and fixed, because if it is not rigid and fixed, then there are chances that there will be an accident. So core box handle needs to be checked proper fitting for proper fitting, and it should not be loose as it can cause you an accident. So it is very important. Then we go next is core box damage. Core box damage. Check core box for damage. One has to keep core boxes properly in the racks, and to avoid damage, handle them with care. It is very important that you have to handle the core box properly with care, because core boxes are integral part of tooling, and without core box and cores, you cannot run the production. So if you have any issue with the core box, it get damaged, or there is a scratch, or there is dead mark, and you are not able to produce the core, your production will be getting stopped. So it's very important that you treat core box equally important like a pattern. So it's very important. And that is why you have to keep it safe with proper care in the well-designed core box storage rack, and you identify it as we have discussed earlier. Take care while ejecting core, as a metallic hammer is not used. Very important that many times when we take out the core after the core has been produced, we use metallic hammer, and it, because of metallic hammer, the core box surface get damaged. So only use wooden hammer to avoid damages of core boxes. This will again give rise to leakage of the sand through the gap across the parting line. Because of you put a metallic hammer on the surface of the core box, the parting line area will get damaged, and there are chances that the sand will get leakage from that gap and that area, and you will not get proper quality of core because of that gap. You can, I'm just sharing with some of the photographs of how the damage can occur. So these damages are not acceptable. These damages are not required. So you have to avoid it by using only wooden hammer. Do not use metallic hammer. Core box. Similarly, one has to take care of loose pieces. There are many core boxes where some loose pieces are there, and it happens that many times we do not handle those loose pieces carefully, and they got skip or they got misplaced. So it is there are chances that it can get misplaced. So similarly, one has to take care of loose piece if any, need to be kept them safely, and as loose piece are small in nature and loose in nature, there are chances that it can get misplaced. So there should be a separate system where you can store those loose pieces part-wise and core box-wise with proper identification. And whenever you want it, you can able to easily get it for your production. So it is very important to handle those loose pieces carefully. Next one is core box venting. Air venting is very important in any core box, any type of core box. And one has to check whether core box has enough vents and are in good condition, because venting is very important. It is provided in the core box to pass out the air while shooting, as it helps in filling the core properly, even in deep drawn areas and critical areas. So if you want to have a good core finish at deep drawn area and at critical areas, you need to have proper venting of in the core box. Not only proper venting in the core box, you need to clean them regularly. So important of air venting and cleaning it regularly in the core box is very, very important. So some snaps I am showing ahead how to clean the vents in the core boxes. This is the way you can clean them regularly. Check the then we go to core box parting line after core box closing. So very important is when you close the core box, there should not be any gap between the parting line. Check the clearance at parting line by closing the both half of the core boxes. It should be zero. If there is any gap in the parting line, it will increase core dimension across the parting line. Core weight will get increased, and also the sand coming out of it due to this gap, core filling will not be good, resulting in bad core. So core filling will not be good. You will not get a good quality of core. There will be not a dense core. It will be a little loose core, and you will not able to get proper quality of core because of the gap at parting line. So core box closing must be one of the important points in inspection of core boxes. Similarly, tightening of clamps where required will help the core box getting exactly closed without any gap at parting line. It is very important to tighten the clamps whenever you are using the clamps properly so that there will not be any gap at the parting line. Also, avoid hammering of core box surface. It is very important to avoid hammering at core box surface. We have already seen this point before. It may cause an uneven surface at parting line and it may cause the sand leakages through the gap where quality of core can get bad. So this is, you can see some of the gap is there because there is no clamp is available. But when you put the clamp, the gap between the parting line vanishes. So it's very important to tighten the clamp wherever possible. Or there may be a nut bolting system available. You have to properly tighten the nut bolts. This is very, very important. Preventing checkpoints. So when the production run starts, there are some preventive points. Number one is after every core, one has to clean the core box with air. So after every core, you have to clean the core box with air. After every 1 hour, one has to clean air vents with the blade, which I have shown you before. Every 4 hours, one has to clean the core box with cleaning agent. Number four, make first piece inspection after every new production run. So every production run, you have to have first piece inspection for visual inspection of core and core boxes. And core box scanning or PDR of the core for dimensional accuracy or dimensional inspection has to be there for check for the worn out of the core boxes every 6 months or 1 year. It depends on your volume, how many core you are producing per month or per day. It depends on that. The volume, the bigger is the volume, your frequency will be less. Less is the volume, your frequency will be high. So by this way, you can decide your own frequency there based on your volumes. This is a simple chart I have made for you. Preventive checkpoints, whatever 5 points we discussed, the same are put up here. The core box cleaning with cleaning solution before start of production. Core box cleaning with air every core. Then core box air vent cleaning every hour. First piece inspection visual initial 5 samples. The dimension inspection of core every 6 months or 1 year. So this is the preventive checklist. So thank you very much for your time. And I hope you enjoyed it and you will follow all the steps in your core making, before core making and during the production run, and take care of the core boxes. And this will definitely help you in getting good quality of cores. Thank you.